Yesterday, I was with my teenager at a college open house, and one of the guys on the panel talked about how he learned that thinking of his dreams not just as dreams but as goals helped them to seem like they weren't way out there, pie in the sky. And that's sort of how I feel about even the biggest dream, that if you can break it down into manageable chunks, and if you can focus on the next thing that's in front of you, that is the secret. That is the key to manifesting even the biggest dream. So let's take living here in Malibu, which for a lot of people could potentially be the biggest dream of like having a gorgeous home in Malibu. And for us, it started out with listing out the things that we wanted our house to be. So just putting it down on paper. What is the dream? What is the vision? Getting as specific as we could get about it. But then it really was just a series of steps that we needed to take. And it was steps related to the law of attraction, but it was also steps related to the practical action that needed to be taken, whether it was, okay, are we going to sell our house or are we going to rent it out? Are we going to, you know, you work with a realtor or are we not? Okay, if we're going to work with a realtor, then let's find a realtor, you know, those kind of things. And some of those things manifested really magically. Like we were out at dinner and my daughter was looking at Zillow and she was like, oh, this house is gorgeous, let's call. And it didn't end up being the house, but it did end up being the realtor. So understanding that it's going to be a combination of practical action and magical manifestation that when broken down into manageable chunks and done one day at a time, one action at a time, will eventually lead to the thing that you're manifesting as long as you hold the intention and keep moving forward.